cause girls is players too. What you know about living on the top? Penthouse suites, looking down on the ops. Took him for a test drive, left him on the lot. Time is money, so I spend it on a watch. Hold on, low T showing through the white tee. You can see the thong busting on my tight
jeans. Mr. Unofficial here. Today we are reviewing Brick Oven Bakery, located off of North 4th Street in Bismarck, North Dakota. Let's jump in. So, atmosphere was really nice. They had a really, almost like a coffee house. They had several baristas working, and people were working on their computers and such. I didn't get the chance to check if there was Wi-Fi. I should have, but I did not. That was my fault. So I won't dock them anything for that. But atmosphere overall was pretty good. So we're going to go with a 3 out of 3. I liked everything there. The music was good. The people were really nice. It was really good. So atmosphere, 3 out of 3. Service, the gal that helped me was really friendly. I got the name of a pastry that I don't really know. We'll get into that. It looks almost just like a big strawberry cream pastry. I got a chocolate-filled croissant. Usually I would have done something savory, but we just went all sweet this morning. And then I asked the gal for the... I'd like something cold that didn't have... caffeine in it, and so she recommended this passion fruit tea. So enough of me blabbing. The service, only thing I would say was these pastries are a little bit spendy. I know like the chocolate croissant was like $5 and the cream puff pastry was $4, and then with the drink I spent like just north of $15, and they didn't have an option for tipping. So price is a little bit steep. That's the only reason why the service would get docked, and it would be a 2 out of 3. But going into the food, we're at a 5 out of 6. So a really solid score for a really nice breakfast place here. So enough blabbing. First thing we're going to do is try this chocolate croissant. I like the way that that looks. You can see that they pipe some good chocolate in there. I mean, not a lot of chocolate, like a little string of it. Not the best chocolate to croissant ratio. Really nice flaky texture. Good flavor. Buttery, crispy croissant. Good. Overall, good item. This was what I was really excited about. And like I said, I'm not even going to try. Even when I ordered it, I told the gal I'm not going to try to pronounce that. It started with an M. It was a marzipati or something like that. So she said it was a strawberry cream pastry with a little powdered sugar on top. Yum. The filling is light, which is good. There we go. Pretty good ratio on this one of filling to bread compared to the chocolate or something, which you kind of have to have when you're doing something filled with cream. I like that one. Both of those were really, really good. Now we got to get into this tea. Like I said, I don't usually do teas or whatever, but the gal said this was the only thing they had that wasn't caffeinated. It was a passion fruit tea, and I had them put a shot of raspberry sweetener in there. Very tangy. The passion fruit has a good mix. Food is good. Not my taste usually for breakfast. Like I said, the croissant was good. I just wish it had more chocolate in there. If you're going to tell me you're giving me a chocolate croissant, and what's really big on the internet now is these viral croissants where you're picking it apart and you're just seeing chocolate. But in this one, you're seeing, I mean, guys, this is all croissant. You know what I mean? I mean, this is like the smallest string of chocolate in there and just a ton of croissant. So that's my biggest knock on that, is you got to put more chocolate in the chocolate croissants. So foods of three. So we had a three, a two, and a three for a grand total. 8 out of 10. Mr. Unofficial, get you next time.